home in need of a little spice? Stop in and see all the home decorations we have to offer. Looking for a gift for someone special? Well, we have something for every occasion. Come on down to Parkston Main Street for all your pharmacy needs. While you're here, check out the many treasures you will find in store.
Welcome to MDS Manufacturing, Inc., serving agriculture for over 50 years and creating tools that help you unleash your loader's potential. We are the premier manufacturer of agricultural attachment equipment. Our products are engineered and designed for quality, convenience, reliability, versatility, value, and safety. For over 50 years, we have been listening to our clients and working with them to provide products that improve their tractor loader needs. MDS Manufacturing in Parkston is leading the way with quality. Call or click today and let us help you pick out the best attachment that will do the job you want it to do. 1301 South Dakota Highway 37. Call 800-658-4703 or visit attachmentspecialist.com.
Shane Fish & Company Incorporated, your local certified public accountants. In need of an audit or simply needing to file your tax return, with helpful and friendly staff, they will be sure to put your books in order. Stop in at 105 East Main Street or call 605-928-7241 to see how they can help you. Shoe Painting is ready to tackle all your painting needs. Their attention to detail with an uncompromised finish sets them apart. Shoe Painting has done everything from homes to churches to garage floors. To get a quote for your next painting project, contact Shoe Painting at 605-996-1243 or stop in at 2019 East Havens Avenue, Mitchell, South Dakota, 57301.
It's a high-tech world for everyone, and everyone deserves connection.
Santel Communications is proud to be a supporter of Trojan TV. For over 60 years, Santel has connected thousands of customers to the world. We are your trusted and local leader in television entertainment, broadband, computers, and network connectivity. Click Santel.net, call 796-4411, or visit our office in Woonsocket.
We perfected connected Santel.
When life happens, trust the experts at Tracy's Paint and Body. Tracy's Paint and Body is a full-service auto body repair shop in Parkston. We feature 24-hour tow service along with full auto body repairs, ranging from windshield and hail dent repairs all the way to full vehicle body overhauls. We also feature full classic vehicle and tractor restoration. For the best price and the best service, visit Tracy's Paint and Body at 908 South Bend Street in Parkston or call 928-7600.
You, your machines, your operators, and Notaboom implements all working together through advanced practices and operating efficiencies to optimize quality, yield, and profits. Welcome to John Deere Farm Site, a strategy built around three key elements: your farm equipment, our technology solutions, your John Deere dealer. Notaboom implements, now more than ever. The future of farming is in sight at Notaboom Implements in Corsica, Chamberlain, Parkston, and Platte, South Dakota. 100% family owned and operated.
CHS Farmers Alliance, serving East Central South Dakota. Farmers Alliance is a full-service agricultural cooperative. Our primary locations include Alexandria, Bridgewater, Chamberlain, Corsica, Ethan, Huron, Mitchell, Storla, and White Lake. Our primary purpose at Farmers Alliance is to help our customers succeed, for only then can Farmers Alliance be successful. This will be accomplished by providing superior products and creative solutions in agronomy, energy, feed, and grain. For more information, visit our website, www.farmersalliance.coop. Hanke Tractor Repair in Parkston is a family-owned and operated business, offering the best in service, parts, and accessories for Articat, Toro, Ferris, Snapper, and Steel. We can handle all of your ATV, UTV, and lawn and garden equipment needs. We feature many products ranging from lawnmowers, chainsaws, leaf blowers, and other outdoor power equipment. We offer a full lineup of vehicles from Articat, and we also offer full-service repairs on your equipment. Come check out our selection, Hanke Tractor Repair, 711 West Maple, Parkston. It's at HankyTractorRepair.com or call 928-3252. Precision machining.
Parkston Drug, your local hometown pharmacy and gifts. Find many fabulous accessories ranging from jewelry to purses and so much more. Is your home in need of a little spice? Stop in and see all the home decorations we have to offer. Looking for a gift for someone special? Well, we have something for every occasion. Come on down to Parkston Main Street for all your pharmacy needs. While you're here, check out the many treasures you will find in store.
Welcome to MDS Manufacturing, Inc., serving agriculture for over 50 years and creating tools that help you unleash your loader's potential. We are the premier manufacturer of agricultural attachment equipment. Our products are engineered and designed for quality, convenience, reliability, versatility, value, and safety. For over 50 years, we have been listening to our clients and working with them to provide products that improve their tractor loader needs. MDS Manufacturing in Parkston is leading the way with quality. Call or click today and let us help you pick out the best attachment that will do the job you want it to do. 1301 South Dakota Highway 37. Call 800-658-4703 or visit attachmentspecialist.com.
Shane Fish & Company Incorporated, your local certified public accountants. In need of an audit or simply needing to file your tax return, with helpful and friendly staff, they will be sure to put your books in order. Stop in at 105 East Main Street or call 605-928-7241 to see how they can help you. Shoe Painting is ready to tackle all your painting needs. Their attention to detail with an uncompromised finish sets them apart. Shoe Painting has done everything from homes to churches to garage floors. To get a quote for your next painting project, contact Shoe Painting at 605-996-1243 or stop in at 2019 East Havens Avenue, Mitchell, South Dakota, 57301.
It's a high-tech world for everyone, and everyone deserves connection.
Santel Communications is proud to be a supporter of Trojan TV. For over 60 years, Santel has connected thousands of customers to the world. We are your trusted and local leader in television entertainment, broadband, computers, and network connectivity. Click Santel.net, call 796-4411, or visit our office in Woonsocket.
We perfected connected Santel.
When life happens, trust the experts at Tracy's Paint and Body. Tracy's Paint and Body is a full-service auto body repair shop in Parkston. We feature 24-hour tow service along with full auto body repairs, ranging from windshield and hail vent repairs all the way to full vehicle body overhauls. We also feature full classic vehicle and tractor restoration. For the best price and the best service, visit Tracy's Paint and Body at 908 South Bend Street in Parkston or call 928-7600.
You, your machines, your operators, and Notaboom implements all working together through advanced practices and operating efficiencies to optimize quality, yield, and profits. Welcome to John Deere Farm Site, a strategy built around three key elements: your farm equipment, our technology solutions, your John Deere dealer, Notaboom implements. Now more than ever, the future of farming is in sight at Notaboom implements in Corsica, Chamberlain, Parkston, and Platte, South Dakota. 100% family owned and operated.
CHS Farmers Alliance, serving East Central South Dakota. Farmers Alliance is a full-service agricultural cooperative. Our primary locations include Alexandria, Bridgewater, Chamberlain, Corsica, Ethan, Huron, Mitchell, Storla, and White Lake. Our primary purpose at Farmers Alliance is to help our customers succeed, for only then can Farmers Alliance be successful. This will be accomplished by providing superior products and creative solutions in agronomy, energy, feed, and grain. For more information, visit our website, www.farmersalliance.coop. Hanke Tractor Repair in Parkston is a family-owned and operated business, offering the best in service, parts, and accessories for Articat, Toro, Ferris, Snapper, and Steel. We can handle all of your ATV, UTV, and lawn and garden equipment needs. We feature many products ranging from lawnmowers, chainsaws, leaf blowers, and other outdoor power equipment. We offer a full lineup of vehicles from Articat, and we also offer full-service repairs on your equipment. Come check out our selection, Hanke Tractor Repair, 711 West Maple, Parkston. Visit HankeTractorRepair.com or call 928-3252. Parts and Precision Machining.
Parkston Drug, your local hometown pharmacy and gifts. Find many fabulous accessories ranging from jewelry to purses and so much more. Is your home in need of a little spice? Stop in and see all the home decorations we have to offer. Looking for a gift for someone special? Well, we have something for every occasion. Come on down to Parkston Main Street for all your pharmacy needs. While you're here, check out the many treasures you will find in store.
Welcome to MDS Manufacturing, Inc., serving agriculture for over 50 years and creating tools that help you unleash your loader's potential. We are the premier manufacturer of agricultural attachment equipment. Our products are engineered and designed for quality, convenience, reliability, versatility, value, and safety. For over 50 years, we have been listening to our clients and working with them to provide products that improve their tractor loader needs. MDS Manufacturing in Parkston is leading the way with quality. Call or click today and let us help you pick out the best attachment that will do the job you want it to do. 1301 South Dakota Highway 37. Call 800-658-4703 or visit attachmentspecialist.com.
Shane Fish & Company Incorporated, your local certified public accountants. In need of an audit or simply needing to file your tax return, with helpful and friendly staff, they will be sure to put your books in order. Stop in at 105 East Main Street or call 605-928-7241 to see how they can help you. Shoe Painting is ready to tackle all your painting needs. Their attention to detail with an uncompromised finish sets them apart. Shoe Painting has done everything from homes to churches to garage floors. To get a quote for your next painting project, contact Shoe Painting at 605-996-1243 or stop in at 2019 East Havens Avenue, Mitchell, South Dakota, 57301.
It's a high-tech world for everyone, and everyone deserves connection.
Santel Communications is proud to be a supporter of Trojan TV. For over 60 years, Santel has connected thousands of customers to the world. We are your trusted and local leader in television entertainment, broadband, computers, and network connectivity. Click Santel.net, call 796-4411, or visit our office in Woonsocket.
We perfected connected Santel.
When life happens, trust the experts at Tracy's Paint and Body. Tracy's Paint and Body is a full-service auto body repair shop in Parkston. We feature 24-hour tow service along with full auto body repairs, ranging from windshield and hail dent repairs all the way to full vehicle body overhauls. We also feature full classic vehicle and tractor restoration. For the best price and the best service, visit Tracy's Paint and Body at 908 South Bend Street in Parkston or call 928-7600.
You, your machines, your operators, and Notaboom implements all working together through advanced practices and operating efficiencies to optimize quality, yield, and profits. Welcome to John Deere Farm Site, a strategy built around three key elements: your farm equipment, our technology solutions, your John Deere dealer, Notaboom implements. Now more than ever, the future of farming is in sight at Notaboom implements in Corsica, Chamberlain, Parkston, and Platte, South Dakota. 100% family owned and operated.
CHS Farmers Alliance, serving East Central South Dakota. Farmers Alliance is a full-service agricultural cooperative. Our primary locations include Alexandria, Bridgewater, Chamberlain, Corsica, Ethan, Huron, Mitchell, Storla, and White Lake. Our primary purpose at Farmers Alliance is to help our customers succeed, for only then can Farmers Alliance be successful. This will be accomplished by providing superior products and creative solutions in agronomy, energy, feed, and grain. For more information, visit our website, www.farmersalliance.coop. Hanke Tractor Repair in Parkston is a family-owned and operated business, offering the best in service, parts, and accessories for Articat, Toro, Ferris, Snapper, and Steel. We can handle all your ATV, UTV, and lawn. feature many products ranging from lawnmowers, chainsaws, leaf blowers, and other outdoor power equipment. We offer a full lineup of vehicles through Articat, and we also offer full service repairs on your equipment. Come check out our selection, Hanky Tractor Repair, 711 West Maple, Parkston. Visit HankyTractorRepair.com or call 928-3252. Precision machining.
Parkston Drug, your local hometown pharmacy and gifts. Find many fabulous accessories ranging from jewelry to purses and so much more. Is your home in need of a little spice? Stop in and see all the home decorations we have to offer. Looking for a gift for someone special? Well, we have something for every occasion. Come on down to Parkston Main Street for all your pharmacy needs. While you're here, check out the many treasures you will find in store.
Welcome to MDS Manufacturing, Inc., serving agriculture for over 50 years and creating tools that help you unleash your loader's potential. We are the premier manufacturer of agricultural attachment equipment. Our products are engineered and designed for quality, convenience, reliability, versatility, value, and safety. For over 50 years, we have been listening to our clients and working with them to provide products that improve their tractor loader needs. MDS Manufacturing in Parkston is leading the way with quality. Call or click today and let us help you pick out the best attachment that will do the job you want it to do. 1301 South Dakota Highway 37. Call 800-658-4703 or visit attachmentspecialist.com.
Shane Fish & Company Incorporated, your local certified public accountants. In need of an audit or simply needing to file your tax return, with helpful and friendly staff, they will be sure to put your books in order. Stop in at 105 East Main Street or call 605-928-7241 to see how they can help you. Shoe Painting is ready to tackle all your painting needs. Their attention to detail with an uncompromised finish sets them apart. Shoe Painting has done everything from homes to churches to garage floors. To get a quote for your next painting project, contact Shoe Painting at 605-996-1243 or stop in at 2019 East Havens Avenue, Mitchell, South Dakota, 57301.
It's a high-tech world for everyone, and everyone deserves connection.
Santel Communications is proud to be a supporter of Trojan TV. For over 60 years, Santel has connected thousands of customers to the world. We are your trusted and local leader in television entertainment, broadband, computers, and network connectivity. Click Santel.net, call 796-4411, or visit our office in Woonsocket.
We perfected connected Santel.
When life happens, trust the experts at Tracy's Paint and Body. Tracy's Paint and Body is a full-service auto body repair shop in Parkston. We feature 24-hour tow service along with full auto body repairs, ranging from windshield and hail dent repairs all the way to full vehicle body overhauls. We also feature full classic vehicle and tractor restoration. For the best price and the best service, visit Tracy's Paint and Body at 908 South Bend Street in Parkston or call 928-7600.
You, your machines, your operators, and Notaboom implements all working together through advanced practices and operating efficiencies to optimize quality, yield, and profits. Welcome to John Deere Farm Site, a strategy built around three key elements: your farm equipment, our technology solutions, your John Deere dealer, Notaboom implements. Now more than ever, the future of farming is in sight at Notaboom implements in Corsica, Chamberlain, Parkston, and Platte, South Dakota. 100% family owned and operated.
CA AHS Farmers Alliance, serving East Central South Dakota. Farmers Alliance is a full-service agricultural cooperative. Our primary locations include Alexandria, Bridgewater, Chamberlain, Corsica, Ethan, Huron, Mitchell, Storla, and White Lake. Our primary purpose at Farmers Alliance is to help our customers succeed, for only then can Farmers Alliance be successful. This will be accomplished by providing superior products and creative solutions in agronomy, energy, feed, and grain. For more information, visit our website, www.farmersalliance.coop. Hanke Tractor Repair in Parkston is a family-owned and operated business, offering the best in service, parts, and accessories for Articat, Toro, Ferris, Snapper, and Steel. We can handle all of your ATV, UTV, and lawn and garden equipment needs. We feature many products ranging from lawnmowers, chainsaws, leaf blowers, and other outdoor power equipment. We offer a full lineup of vehicles from Articat, and we also offer full-service repairs on your equipment. Come check out our selection, Hanke Tractor Repair, 711 West Maple, Parkston. Visit HankeTractorRepair.com or call 928-3252. Precision machining.
Parkston Drug, your local hometown pharmacy and gifts. Find many fabulous accessories ranging from jewelry to purses and so much more. Is your home in need of a little spice? Stop in and see all the home decorations we have to offer. Looking for a gift for someone special? Well, we have something for every occasion. Come on down to Parkston Main Street for all your pharmacy needs. While you're here, check out the many treasures you will find in store.
Welcome to MDS Manufacturing, Inc., serving agriculture for over 50 years and creating tools that help you unleash your loader's potential. We are the premier manufacturer of agricultural attachment equipment. Our products are engineered and designed for quality, convenience, reliability, versatility, value, and safety. For over 50 years, we have been listening to our clients and working with them to provide products that improve their tractor loader needs. MDS Manufacturing in Parkston is leading the way with quality. Call or click today and let us help you pick out the best attachment that will do the job you want it to do. 1301 South Dakota Highway 37. Call 800-658-4703 or visit attachmentspecialist.com.
Shane Fish & Company Incorporated, your local certified public accountants. In need of an audit or simply needing to file your tax return, with helpful and friendly staff, they will be sure to put your books in order. Stop in at 105 East Main Street or call 605-928-7241 to see how they can help you. Shoe Painting is ready to tackle all your painting needs. Their attention to detail with an uncompromised finish sets them apart. Shoe Painting has done everything from homes to churches to garage floors. To get a quote for your next painting project, contact Shoe Painting at 605-996-1243 or stop in at 2019 East Havens Avenue, Mitchell, South Dakota, 57301.
It's a high-tech world for everyone, and everyone deserves connection.
Santel Communications is proud to be a supporter of Trojan TV. For over 60 years, Santel has connected thousands of customers to the world. We are your trusted and local leader in television entertainment, broadband, computers, and network connectivity. click Santel.net, call 796. When life happens, when life
there we go. Good job, guys. We are in Region 3, winner leading our region right now with a 4-0 record. They have 46.25 points. Chamberlain currently in second with 42 points. They are 3-0. Bridgewater Emery Ethan, 41.5. They are 2-2. Parkston sitting at 40 points, 2-2. And Wagner sitting at 38.67. So if you finish in the top four in the region, then you make the playoffs. The number four seed will take on the number one seed. So Parkston looking to get a victory here. They want to kind of try to stay away from winter as much as possible, as do all of our teams in our region, I believe, right now. So it looks like the coin toss will be won by Parkston. They will defer to the second half. I will assume that Wagner will take the ball. Let's see here. Little discussion. Okay, I'm going to say Parkston's going to take the ball. Or excuse me, Wagner's going to take the ball. There we go. Something new this year. After they announce everybody and they do the national anthem, then they flip the coin. So everybody knows what's going on. Parkston looks like they are going to defend the south goal tonight. There is a little bit of wind coming from the south. So we're going to get ready to go here. There we go. Good job. Once again, this is run by the Parkston Media Club. Students are doing the camera work, doing the graphics work, and also doing the producing. So our producer this game, Liam McIntosh. On the graphics, we have TJ Biggie. Okay. Tony's going to get him helped out here, and then we're going to get going. They're getting lined up for kickoff. Jordan McKean will kick off. Homecoming King, Jordan McKean will kick off. And for Wagner, back deep. Number 21, Ben Sokup. Is that number 15? Amelia Courier. McKean's kick is going to go into the end zone. That'll be a touchback in high school football. That ball on the kickoff gets into the end zone. That is an automatic touchback. So Wagner will take over first and 10 from the 20-yard line. Wagner coming in with a 1-2 record. They just defeated Jones County White River 40-16 last week. Parkston was up in Redfield, and they defeated Redfield Doland 46-0. So both teams coming off a victory. We'll see how they do here. Number four, Jace Faulkner, lining up at quarterback, a sophomore. Man in motion. The handoff up the middle. He's going to be brought down by number 72, Paul Peterson. Looks like it's going to lose a yard. That handoff was number two, Noah Flying Hawk. He's brought down. Second down and 11. We all good to go, Tone?
I think we are good to go.
Good to hear. Tony's been running around trying to get everything set up for us here. Tony Kinnenberg, the mastermind behind the Parkston Media Club.
Yeah, master of something. I don't know.
So second and 11 here for Wagner. Oh. We'll see here. There is movement on both sides. It looks like it's going to be on Parkston here. So it'll be a 5-yard penalty. Be second down and 6. So on the defensive side, always told to watch the football. Don't listen to the quarterback. Why? When the football moves, you move. Faulkner at quarterback. Here's the snap. Handoff up the middle. Paul Peterson, yeah. Noah Reichert, and Blake Beats going to meet him right as he's handing off the ball. That was the number 21, Ben Sokup.
All I saw was big number 72, and he didn't move.
He did not. So it'll be 3rd and 9, loss of 3 yards there for Wagner. Once again, if you're out there in the Twitterverse on Twitter, the Parks and Media Club likes to know where you are watching from. So would you let us know? Hashtag MikeKelc2012. I know the Parks and Media Club has a hashtag, Tone. We got to find that. So back to pass. Off to the wing.
Ooh, he's
nice
going to
be
tackle.
Met immediately by Tulsa Janish. That's going to be a loss of about 4 yards. So I'm going to put it 4th and 13, Tony. Good start here on defense for the Trojans. Except for jumping off sides there.
Okay, they have their little hashtag up top. Let us know. Also, let us know how we're doing on the sound. I didn't get a chance to do a major sound check, but so if anyone's out there and watching on Santel TV or something, hashtag us and let us know what. Where's Mike, so you can check it on your phone and see how our volume is.
All right, so Dawson Semler going to get that punt. He's going to run it back to about the 37-yard line. The Trojans will take over 1st and 10. 9:46 left in the first quarter. Once again, new scoreboard, compliments of Farmer State Bank, and we still need to get our hardware to make it work together. So
yeah,
that'll take a little bit.
It takes time, and that's kind of what we've been lacking lately.
Colbert under center. He's going to hand off the left-hand side to Holzbauer. He's going to go down to about...
Looks like he'll get about 10 yards on the carry.
Nice big hole there for Holzbauer. He's going to get to the 25-yard line. That'll be a first down. Nice big hole off the left-hand side. The last few games, the offensive line really has done a nice job opening it up.
Oh, that's the...
Colbert under center. McKean to the top of the screen. Beats and Holzbauer and Beats in the backfield. Hand off to Blake Beats on the right-hand side. He's going to get to the outside. One man to beat. He's going to get to the right-hand corner and touchdown. Blake Beats with a 25-yard touchdown scamper off the right-hand side. That's good for 6. Had a nice hole there. Got a nice block from Jordan McKean downfield. That'll make the score 6-0. And it looks like we're going to line up for 2 here. Luke Beats at fullback, number 31. Blake Beats, number 35. Kyler Holzbauer, number 27. Number 11, Kellen Colbert under center. And off to Holzbauer off the left-hand side. Good for 2. So with 9:21 left in the first quarter, Parkston 8, Wagner 0. We have a commercial, Tom? Have we been working on some new ones yet?
We have 3 that we're working on right now with the media class, and we're hoping that we'll have them ready for the next home football game.
All right, good deal. The next home football game will be against Winter in 2 weeks, as the boys next week travel to Jones County White River. That's about, what is that, about 30 miles south of the Myrtle? Is that right?
Well, I thought when I looked on it said they play in Myrtle, but is that right?
Oh, maybe, is that it?
I don't know.
All right. Okay. All right. Wagner coach. Oh. Okay.
I just remember seeing it on one of the schedule where it said in parentheses Myrtle.
Okay.
So.
They got both fields?
Okay.
Okay. So maybe that'll be in Myrtle, which is right on the interstate, so that's good.
Could stop in, isn't that where they have the antique
car,
shop there?
Antique cars? Elvis Presley's car?
Yeah, they have all the...
I don't know that I've been there in a while, so...
Yeah, it's been 25 years since we were there last, I think.
All right, so Jordan McKean getting ready to kick off again. Once again, Trojans. Wagner gets the ball first. Trojans hold him on three straight downs. And then they march down the field on 3 plays, and Blake Beats, 25-yard touchdown run. McKean to kick. Good kick. down to about the 5-yard line, and that's going to go into the end zone once again.
Rolls out the back.
And that's a touchback. So Wagner will take over first and 10 from the 20-yard line.
Yes, our next home event will be Monday as MVP comes to town. That's always a good rival for Parkston.
Mount Vernon Plank, you bet. Have those seniors graduated from there yet?
Yes, a few of them have.
Okay. Seemed like some of those girls have been there for 5-6 years, so.
Yeah.
Wagner will take over first and 10, 20-yard line. Four split out wide. Back to pass. A nice job there, Braden Leishner, the outside linebacker, covers Ben Soakup, and the quarterback, I think, just kind of threw it away there, Tony. Second and 10. So, homecoming festivities today. We had the pep rally, had the barbecue, had
yes,
the parade.
Parade. Pep rally. It was a really good pep rally today.
Yeah. The
one of the loudest I've heard, with the student body yelling at each other back and forth.
The elementary is always loud.
Yeah.
The high school got into it.
They really got into it today.
They didn't want to be shown up by the elementary school. And second and 10.
Band did an excellent job for small numbers, and it's good to see them perform. Yeah. And
Faulkner's pass intended for number 32, Alex Sully. That is incomplete. Braden Leishner with the pressure there. So third and 10.
They'd say, but we're going to have to tell Todd to wear a hat. Reflection is kind of throwing our cameras off a little bit.
Too shiny. I'll see if I can send him a text message. I'm sure he'll appreciate that. Danita, if you're out there listening, would you let him know, please? Faulkner back to pass. Ball is up. Janish is there.
Oh.
And it'll fall incomplete. Nice job by both guys there. Colton Fry, the intended receiver for Wagner. It'll be incomplete. Tulsa Janice there, step for step. That'll bring up fourth and 10. 9:07 left here to go in the first quarter. The sun has gone down now, so it's all better.
Oh, he's in the shade.
Yep. Good punt. Semler to receive. Oh, ball's on the ground. Get on it. Get on it. Yep.
The Trojans will take over at Wagner's 47-yard line.
Yep. Kind of looked like he was starting to run before he caught the ball, so that happens.
Yeah, and looked like he almost caught it at the shoe top there. Once again, a beautiful night.
The wind has gone down from today during the parade. All right, so Trojans, first and 10 from Wagner's 47-yard line.
Colbert under center. Of course, he's got relatives in Wagner.
Yes, he does. Luke Beats up the middle. He's going to get 10 yards. Yeah, he's going to get 11 yards.
11 yards, yes.
No flags. They're going to move the chains. First and 10.
I told Larry Fergan, I said, you better hope the wind doesn't go down too much, because I know the one night the mosquitoes were terrible.
Yeah, when we came out Tuesday night for coronation, and they came out for the burning of the PHS.
I think they sprayed for it, but.
Yeah. Yeah. Mayor Dave Hoffman was out spraying the other day, I saw. So. Holzbauer split out to the left. McKean to the top of your screen. He's going to go in motion. Colbert, hand off to Beats. Ooh. He's going to be brought down quickly by number 32, Alex Sully. And Truman Ashes, number 59, also in on that tackle. Loss of 1 yard. It'll be second and 11.
By the way, at halftime, we will stick around for a while because our Canton royalty will be walking in front of us before the crowd, so we'll get that on TV. I thought they were going to do the cheerleading, but they didn't do that today because they needed special padding in case that somebody dropped somebody. So
Blake Beats carries up the middle for about 8 yards, but we have a flag down, and it looks like it's going to be a face mask. Face mask on Wagner. That's going to be, I believe it's 15 yards no matter what now, I think, Tony. It used to be either a 5 or a 15, but now, oh, no, it's only a 5. Okay, but that's good enough for a Trojan first down. I thought they had changed that. My bad. 7:56 left in the first quarter. McKean split out to the top of your screen. Colbert back to pass.
Got a flag.
McKean in the corner of the end zone. No, right around the 2-yard line, but we got a flag down. I'm going to say that flag's probably for an illegal procedure. We only had 5 guys in the line. Looks like Jim Johnson. Legal formation. That's going to be declined, so it'll be 2nd and 10. Need to have 7 guys on the line of scrimmage. It kind of looked like you said we only had 5, so. Holzbauer on the line, on the bottom of your screen. McKean split to the top. Pitch outside to Beats. Oh, he's going to slip a couple tackles, and he's going to get out. Looks like about 6 yards, Tony? 7
Can't
yards?
Quite see.
I thought we were going to wash these windows.
Need to move the wall, too.
We're going to get 9 yards there. I'm going to say 3rd and a long 1. Nice blocking out front there for Beats. Luke Beats with the ball going up the middle. I think he'll
have got it first down.
Let's see.
Where he's marking it, it's going to be awfully close.
2nd down? No. 4th down.
Fourth
there,
down.
Sam. 4th and 1. Looks like fourth the Trojans are going to go for it.
Looks like a short one.
Colbert under center. Hand off to Blake Beats. He's going to cut up the middle. And he's going to get enough for the first down. He's going to pick up about 3.
Yeah, it's not.
It'll be first and goal from the 9-yard line for the Trojans. Lineman doing a nice job opening up holes. Oh, Holzbauer going to run into Alex Sully in the backfield.
Looks going to lose about 5 yards on it. Well, it looks like you're going to lose about 6 yards.
Ran into Sully there. And then did Johnson finish him off, I heard Mr. Acree say?
Yes.
I just gave props to the offensive line.
2nd down and 16. And that's 16 to the goal line. Colbert under center. Rolls out to pass to the right,
Leichner,
wide open
wide
if you
open.
Get it to him. There you go.
Touchdown, Trojans. A 16-yard pass from Colbert to Leichner is good for 6. Looks like Trojans will line up for 2.
Nice pass by Colbert. I thought, boy, it's wide open for a long time there.
Leichner went through there looking like he was going to block and ran right by everybody.
5:07 here to go in the first quarter. Parkson going for two. Corbett under center, drops back to pass. Pass out, and he's going to be in for an extra two.
Braden Leichner with that reception.
Nice pass by Colbert.
Good protection, too, for the line. So Trojans will take lead 16-0 in the first quarter. 5:07 left. Trying to get it out here. And
with that, we'll take a break. 30 seconds.
When life happens, trust the experts at Tracy's Paint and Body. Tracy's Paint and Body is a full-service auto body repair shop in Parkston. We feature 24-hour tow service along with full auto body repairs, ranging from windshield and hail dent repairs all the way to full vehicle body overhauls. We also feature full classic vehicle and tractor restoration. For the best price and the best service, visit Tracy's Paint and Body at 908 South Bend Street in Parkston or call 928-7600.
You.
All right, and we're back. Trojans 16, Wagner 0. 5:07 left in the first quarter. It was a 16-yard pass from Kellen Colbert to Braden Leichner. And then they tacked on the two with a 2-3-yard pass from Colbert to Leichner again. I believe that might be Braden's third touchdown catch of the year.
They were just welcoming all the from the class of 1961, right?
It's 1961, right?
61 or 60?
Yep, 61. It would be 61. Their 55th year. And I know we have some others in as well.
1991
is here, celebrating their 25th, excuse me. And I believe the class of 66 is also here. They're going to recognize them here in the first quarter as well, I believe. And that is their 50th.
So.
Yeah. Yeah, they are. So I'm supposed to golf with them tomorrow, so we'll see. Wagner will take over first and 10 from about the 26-yard line.
Miss Rylance, you're looking for something to do. You can clean our windows.
You see how bad these are? Pass is incomplete. Just don't fall down, please.
You notice when I ask her something to do, she takes off.
Oh, now she's gone. What's going on?
But oh no, if the scoreboard don't work.
Yeah, then.
All we're asking is just someone to do the windows. Yeah. And
I'm wondering. Insect fogger. There's some stuff up here, but it doesn't look like window cleaner, Tony. Wagner has four out wide.
Pass up the middle, no good, a little too strong.
Emilio Cornoyer is incomplete. Be third and 10. Once again, this is put on by the Parkston Media Club, so if you are out there and you have a Twitter account, please let us know where you're watching from. I think last game we had someone watching from Tennessee, Grandma watching from Tennessee. She appreciated that. Inside screen.
Ooh.
It'll be caught, but it'll be caught for a loss.
It was
number,
almost caught.
Number 81.
Who's number 50 for us?
AJ St. Pierre, Brady Schoenfelder.
He almost had it in his mitts, too. And
knocked it out of there.
I'll have to ask Brady. Maybe that's why they put you on a line instead of receiver, huh?
Yeah, hands of a lineman. That'll be fourth and 12 for Wagner. Punt is away. Semler to receive. Tries to cut back up the middle.
Straight up the middle. Nice. Nice
about
return.
About a 12-yard return. Oh. We got a flag down. That's usually probably a hold on the receiving team, probably on us. See what they have to say.
Yeah, it looks like they're going to be marching the other direction, huh? Pushing the back.
Yep. So that'll be a 10-yard penalty.
See, I always thought, you know, that shouldn't be a foul because you're just helping that guy out get faster, right? Push him from behind.
Hurry up, make the play. Trojans, first and 10 from Wagner's 49-yard line. 4:08 left in the first quarter.
Ball on Wagner's 49. Got a full backfield.
Looks like Holzbauer at quarterback. He's going to keep it. He's going to go off the left-hand side. One man to beat.
Well, the first guy slowed him down enough for...
Well, for
number
Noah
two.
Flying Hawk to make the tackle. Colbert was on the left-hand side there as a wide receiver. Did a nice job there with the option. Looks like he's handing off to the fullback, and he reads what's going on. If he thinks the fullback can get it, he's going to give him the ball. If not, he's going to take it himself and do an
option. First and 10, 3:45 to go here in quarter one.
McKean coming across the field, and he's going to pick up about 7 yards. Came in motion across, flipped it to him. Second and 3 or 4. I'm going to go second and 4. Trojans trying a few things different today than they have in the past.
Got our quarterback running off the field. Who we got?
Looks like Luke Beats.
Beats.
We'll go to the left end. Leishner at the right end. McKean split out top of your screen. Hand off to Blake. No, that would be Dawson Semler.
And he's going to have a first down.
On the left-hand side. Yep, he's going to pick up about 8 yards. Like Tony said, good for a first down.
Sorry, we've been playing this whole quarter on this end, and it's hard to see you. I got a wall right in front of me.
We need to build a second level here, Tony.
That's right.
Or the ceiling. We need to get up on top.
Yeah, they could build us a nice little booth up top for us.
All right. We'll talk to MDS.
Okay.
They're the ones that made this one. We'll see if it's possible. Holzbauer with the keeper. He's not going to get very far. Matter of fact, he might lose a yard. Well, lose about a half a yard there. Not sure if he read that one correctly.
Just coming up here on 2 minutes to go in quarter one. Parkson up 16-0.
Different set here for the Trojans. Holzbauer, quarterback. Going to hand off on the left-hand side to Blake Beats. He's going to pick up about 4 yards. And give us 3rd and 7, Tony, is what I'm going to say.
Yeah.
There, Mr. Acree, thanks for helping out.
It looks like a long 7, though, I got to say.
Luke Beats coming off on the sidelines.
Colbert under center this time.
Blake Beats off the right-hand side. He cuts it back up the middle.
And we got a flag. I think
sure.
We got a hold maybe on
Is that
one.
What it's going to be? Another face mask?
Could be. I thought it looked like someone was pulling from behind, but...
Personal foul. Face mask.
Automatic first down. Be half the distance to the goal line here. First and goal for the Trojans at the 5-yard line.
Parkson quickly up here to line. 107 to go.
Colbert going to keep it. Pass is tipped. See what happens here. Did Leishner stay in bounds? What do we got? Yeah, what do we? We're wait, I haven't seen a signal yet. Touchdown! Colbert was looking, waiting, and for the last second, he threw it. It got tipped by Wagner.
Right into.
And Braden Leishner will pull that one down for his second touchdown of the first quarter here. Now it looks like we're lining up for the extra point. Holzbauer to snap the ball. Scott to hold, McKean to kick. Ball is down, the kick is up.
No good.
That's going to be wide right. So Parkston, third touchdown here in the first quarter. They're up 22-0, 51 seconds left in the first quarter.
Yeah, we'll take a commercial break and we'll be back in 30.
You, your machines, your operators, and Notaboom implements, all working together through advanced practices and operating efficiencies to optimize quality, yield, and profits. Welcome to John Deere Farm Site, a strategy built around three key elements: your farm equipment, our technology solutions, your John Deere dealer. Notaboom implements, now more than ever. The future of farming is in sight at Notaboom Implements in Corsica, Chamberlain, Parkston, and Platte, South Dakota. 100% family owned and operated.
All right, we're back here. 51 seconds left in the first quarter. Trojans with a 22-0 lead over Wagner. It was a 5-yard touchdown pass from Colbert to Leishner. It was tipped up in the air.
Someone should get assist for that one, I think.
Yeah, that only works in basketball,
yeah.
I think. So. But it was tipped in the air by Wagner and came down in the hands of Leishner, kept his feet in bounds.
Low line drive kick, yep. Picked up by Wagner. And they'll take over at their 37.5. 38.
Ball recovered by number 44, Dawson Petrick. I don't know if that was a missed kick or if they were trying something a little different. Wagner looking to get something going here in the first quarter. Jace Faulkner. Sophomore quarterback, number 4. 3 split to the bottom of your screen, 1 split to the top. Faulkner back, going to hand off to Sokup up the middle. He's going to get met right at the line of scrimmage. And whoever hit him, hit him hard. He went nowhere.
Well, I think he's found a wall in there, and I think it's number 72.
Ah.
He's really done a nice job so far.
Paul Peterson. Making his presence felt.
Yes. Second down and 10 as the clock continues to run here. 15 seconds left to go. That'll probably be the last play here of the first quarter.
Quick pass out to the wing. Yeah. Braden Leichner comes down the line, tackles him. That was number eight, Bryce Zephyr. It's good for four or five. Yep. Going to be third and a long five, should we say, Tony. And that's the end of your first quarter. Trojans, three touchdowns in the first quarter. They lead 22-0. We'll be back.
CHS Farmers Alliance, serving East Central South Dakota. Farmers Alliance is a full-service agricultural cooperative. Our primary locations include Alexandria, Bridgewater, Chamberlain, Corsica, Ethan, Huron, Mitchell, Storla, and White Lake. Our primary purpose at Farmers Alliance is to help our customers succeed, for only then can Farmers Alliance be successful. This will be accomplished by providing superior products and creative solutions in agronomy, energy, feed, and grain. For more information, visit our website, www.farmersalliance.coop.
All right, back here to start the second quarter. Wagner with the football, third and a six, we're going to say, a long five. Faulkner back to pass, and it's going to be picked off by number five, Jordan McKean. He's going down the sidelines. Oh, we got a flag, and McKean's going to get tripped up. It's usually a block in the back. We'll see what happens here. McKean read that well, stepped up. Pick the pass off. See what happens here. As they're talking about it, if it is a block in the back, I believe the Trojans will retain possession of the football. But it'll be 10 yards back from the spot of the foul, which have them at about their own 49-yard line. We'll see what they say. Personal foul, unsportsmanlike conduct on Wagner. Oh, wait, or Parkston.
Well, just to let you know, we have a former producer listening tonight.
Oh.
Except he said he was going to start charging us for royalties for his voice on the commercials. Sorry, Dylan, ain't gonna happen. I think you signed a contract and you gave all those rights up to us. Yeah.
So you got to read the fine print there, Dill. So you'll learn. So
that's like Dylan Munson, who has texted me, and he's watching. I would assume at SDSU, where he gets to run the camera on the field during the football game.
So nice.
At least that's what he did. I saw on Facebook that he was he had the big camera on his shoulder, and he was
okay. Cool. I went up there last weekend as we went and toured the campus, and that was, went up to see the new stadium up there in Brookings, and it is nice, very nice. Okay, so the personal foul, he pointed both ways. So.
And so they're both going to move back, right?
I'm not sure what they're doing there.
Well, the Trojans, they moved back. So they must
think.
So
the ball is set, and it's going to be first and 25. Does that sound right? Oh, no. Now the chains are coming with here.
I think the.
They marked it off after the play was over. So that would have.
So first down still.
First and 10 for the Trojans at the 43-yard line. Excuse me, the 32-yard line. Colbert under center again. Quick pass out to McKean. He'll break to the outside. Oh, and he fumbled.
But I believe they got it. Well.
I think Wagner has that one.
I think a Parks tonight may have got it. No, Wagner.
Well, no signal. Second down. Okay.
Well, it looked like the Wagner player gave the ref the ball.
That's what I thought too, but must have missed that. Okay, Faulkner coming off the field, limping a little bit there.
But I do have to say, Liam called it right away. He said, no, it's our ball.
Oh, good call, Liam.
He saw it.
Well, you got the camera angle there. So, hand off to Beats on the right-hand side. He's going to carry for about 3-4 yards.
So
third and three for the Trojans from the 25-yard line. Sorry, Tony, go ahead.
I was just going to say, so Dylan, when the next time you're home, you need to stop in and see me. I got a project for you.
All right.
He's the one that set up our scoreboard for last time.
Oh, okay. I see. So we need to figure out how to do that again.
Yep.
Okay.
And he knows how to do it so quick, and it's for me to have to Google it and figure it out.
Third and three here for the Trojans. Hand off to Beats and up right up the middle. And he's going to pick up 5. That's going to be good enough for a first down. No flags. Looked like that was a little cross play. 10:31 left here in the second quarter.
By the way, it was also nice to see a number, 77 at SDSU getting playing time?
Yeah, Wes Jeanette, former Parkston Trojan. Came in on the third offensive series up there. They pulled his red shirt, so he gets to keep playing. Hand to the left-hand side to Semler. He's going to get caught in the back. Oh, they're going to let him keep going. Truman Ashes there with the first one. They get a hold of him. That's going to lose a yard. Second and 11.
And I'm sorry to say, but, you know, I am a Bison fan, and they kind of defeated Iowa this past weekend.
I did see that. I saw a nice picture out there of all the FBS teams that they've beaten in the last 5 years, and it's impressive. Blake Beats up the middle, and he's not going to get very far.
And I hate to say, but I also went to UND, and sorry, but they also beat USD this weekend.
Oh, good weekend there for. All right, we got a Parkston player down.
Parkston
that
down.
Looks like
number,
Brady Schoenfelder.
Number 50.
I know he's coming back from a slight knee injury. Talked to his mom last night.
He
looks to be in a little bit of pain there. I know that kneecap keeps moving around on him, so. They're going to take a timeout, and so will we. So we'll be back.
Hanke Tractor Repair in Parkston is a family-owned and operated business, offering the best in service, parts, and accessories for Articat, Toro, Ferris, Snapper, and Steel. We can handle all of your ATV, UTV, and log and garden equipment needs. We feature many products ranging from lawnmowers, chainsaws, leaf blowers, and other outdoor power equipment. We offer a full lineup of vehicles from Articat, and we also offer full-service repairs on your equipment. Come check out our selection, Hanke Tractor Repair, 711 West Maple, Parkston. It's at HankeTractorRepair.com or call 928-3252.
All right, and we're back here. Schoenfelder was able to get up and walk off under his own power. Well, hope he's all right. Let's see. Number 56, A.J. Schoenfelder in. Number 66, Alex Scott. One of those two came in for him. I'm sorry, I didn't see who was in the game.
Okay, so Mrs. Rylands comes back up, and I do not see any paper towels or anything in her hand.
Kellen Colbert with a 20-yard touchdown pass, 21-yard touchdown pass to Braden Leichner with his third touchdown catch of the game.
Another nice pass. Cullen is really, I got to give him a shout out because, you know, he's in my media class. So
all right.
I told him, I said, I'm going to give you some voice if you.
No, but at the same time, Colbert has a ton of time to pass back there.
Well, and his receivers have been pretty wide open, too.
Yes, they have. Third touchdown pass and catch for Colbert to Leishner. And they're going to line up for two. 9:22 left in the second quarter. And they go for two up the middle. It is no good. So, Trojans 28, Wagner 0, 9:22 left. We got a new commercial to run at all?
Not yet. I told them, hopefully.
Oh, okay. I misunderstood. I'm sorry. I thought we had them here already.
Nope.
My bad.
My media class is working, and I hope we'll have three new ones by the next.
We'll have to get after Kellen. Tell him to quit screwing around in class.
Well, you know what? If things don't work tonight, it's their fault because that's part of the grade is they had to bring all the equipment over here and set it up and make it work without me telling them how to do it.
Okay. All right.
The
scoreboard was not included in that.
No.
So.
But you can't blame anybody on that one because they shut the power off down at the other end because they were switching out lights, I think.
All right. On the scoreboard, burned out lights already?
Nope.
The lights. Okay. I'm sorry. I was going to say, we get a refund there if the lights are burning on the scoreboard already. All right, Trojans lining up to kick. Jordan McKean once again to kick.
So like I said, if things don't work, you can blame Tucker Murtha and Kellen Colbert because they're the ones that...
All right. Once again, this production put on by the Parkston Media Club, made up of Parkston students ranging from 7th grade all the way up to seniors.
Tonight is just 7th and 8th graders.
7th and 8th graders tonight. All right. Junior high program.
Yep.
Nice job, gentlemen. They run the cameras. They do the graphics.
But I count, I have about 15 kids.
Excellent. This means it's a successful program,
yes.
Tony.
It's going well.
Spit that word out. McKean going to kick the ball out of bounds at about the 20-yard line, and that is a penalty. They can ask to re-kick the ball, or I believe they can take it at the 35, which I'm assuming they'll take it at the 35. Illegal procedure.
Oh, get this. Dylan texts me and goes, believe it or not, I'm home now.
Oh, so he could come out right now and fix it?
Yeah, well, I don't know how quick he can do it.
Oh, all right.
I suppose because SDSU had the week off, didn't they? Got a bye week this week?
They have a bye week for football. That is correct. Wagner is going to take a timeout and get things situated. So we'll hear a word from our sponsors here as well. We'll be back. Okay, we're back after the timeout by Wagner. They take over first and 10 from the 35-yard line here in the second quarter, down 28-0. And he's handoff up the middle to soak up. He's going to be met immediately by number 55, Brady Albrecht. Mr. Acree says loss of three.
Looking for Schoenfelder over there. I don't see a number standing, so I wonder if he's sitting down over there, or I just don't see his number. Took his jersey. Well, I think he's got to play with his jersey on, doesn't he?
If he's going to play, he's got to have a jersey. I'm positive.
There he is.
The only rule I know.
I couldn't figure out. I mistook him for Mr. Gilman standing out there.
Oh, Blake Beetz with the one-handed interception. And he's going to take the ball all the way back down.
And then there's a fumble there.
Oh. We'll see what happens here.
Oh, it's right, Wagner's ball again.
Well, as he was trying to make the return, it looks like he fumbled the ball, which is a change of possession. So Wagner will get the ball back, first and 10, but now from the 21-yard line. That was nice. Blake put up his hand, one-handed, tipped it up in the air, grabbed it again. But then Wagner with a nice job stripping the football. New quarterback in for Wagner, number 10, Colin Frey. He's going to keep it. He's going to be met by Braden Leishner and number 72 there again, Paul Peterson. Colton Frey now in at quarterback. I know when he was on defense, I saw Faulkner kind of limp off to the sidelines, Tony, and I see someone lying down over there. They're working on him. So hope he's all right. Same with Brady Schoenfelder over there. Hope he's all right. Fry back at quarterback. Soak up next to him.
Quick handoff up the middle. Oh, nice tackle. Who is number
55? No, 35. Blake Beetz.
Right on there. If I tell you, he would have had some...
He had some open room.
Open
over
room
here.
There.
You bet.
In fact, he may have saved a touchdown there. I don't know. There was a lot of room there to go.
Third and 5, we're going to say, Tony.
That's what the scoreboard says. It looks about right. Coming up on 7 minutes here in before we get to halftime. Once again, we'll stick around to show our royalty. Nice little story on McKenzie and Jordan on Kelloland.
Fry with a keeper. He's going to go off left-hand side, and he's going to pick up a first down. He's going to pick up about 10 yards there. It's good enough for a Wagner Raider first down.
.6:47 of the clock stops here.
Beetz brothers at linebacker there, 35 Blake, the senior, and number 31 Luke. Your linebacker core there. Fry with a keeper. Oh, and a fumble. Oh, I think he got back on it though, Tony.
Yep, second down, the ref's already saying so. Yep.
It was right there. I think Blake Beetz hit him on the blitz. Caused the fumble, but we couldn't get on it.
And they're going to say second down and 15. 5:50 to go. Where did we say next week they got to go to?
White River.
White River.
White River, Jones County. And we think it might be in Myrtle.
That's what I'm thinking. We'll have to ask Mrs. Rylance next time she's up here.
Huh?
Which probably won't be again because she won't clean our windows anyway.
Screen to the middle. Ooh, he's open. Luke Beetz with a nice tackle.
One leg tackle.
Yeah, he fought off the blocker and made a saving tackle there because there was
nobody
in the middle of the field there. Third and 11 there for the Raiders. Coming up on 5 minutes left before halftime. No marching band this year, is that correct, Tony?
That's correct.
Huh? So there'll be no performance by the band at halftime. Fry in at quarterback now. Five guys split out for Wagner. Coming in motion. Fry's going to keep it. He's off the right-hand side, and he's going to be tackled by number 35, Blake Beats. Going to bring up fourth down and about seven. Good job on the camera work, guys.
Thought they were going to get him in the backfield there, but he ran right by two defenders.
Fry, 6 foot junior.
Fourth down, and what have we got, six?
He's fleet of foot back there, Tony. All right, we got to get that play in here, Coach.
By the way, a beautiful day for a parade. Remember last year we got rained out.
Yep.
Timeout.
All right. Timeout Wagner as the play clock was running down. So with 3:28 left in the before halftime, Parkston leads 28-0. We'll be back.
Precisely. What? You. Need. Parkston Precision Machining.
Parkston Drug, your local hometown pharmacy and gifts. Find many fabulous accessories ranging from jewelry to purses and so much more. Is your home in need of a little spice? Stop in and see all the home decorations we have to offer. Looking for a gift for someone special? Well, we have something for every occasion. Come on down to Parkston Main Street for all your pharmacy needs. While you're here, check out the many treasures you will find in store.
Okay, looks like we are back. 3:28 here to go. If you're just joining us, Parkston up 28-0. Once again, at halftime, we'll stay around here for a little bit as the royalty will walk on the track in front of the grandstand here. And we want to make sure that they get a little air time.
Fry back to pass. And it's going to be knocked out of the air by number 55, Brady Albrecht. And that'll be a turnover on down. Trojans will take over first and 10 from the 42-yard line. Brady kind of was trying to read the quarterback's eyes there, drop back into coverage from the defensive tackle spot and knock that ball down. So 3:23, Trojans will look to try to put it in the end zone before halftime. Kellen Colbert under center. Dawson Semler split to the bottom of your screen, I believe, here. Colbert to pass. He's got time. And there's Leishner again. Oh!
Yeah, fumble out of bounds at about, 12-yard line?
Pass complete to Leishner, but it will remain Parkston football. Huh? He tried to do a cutback and got caught and lost the football. It's the third time the football's popped out tonight, Tony.
It's not even wet out here.
We gotta clean that up a little bit. It'll be something they talk about at halftime. It'll be first and 10 from the 12-yard line. Once again, offensive line doing a nice job. Colbert had all day to throw back there. Colbert, shotgun formation. Blake Beats next to him. Oh, tried to zip it in there to McKean.
He almost, who's number 36 back? He almost tipped it to the guy in the back that was running on the backside.
Leishner running a pattern on the backside. That would have been his second tipped touchdown of the night.
I don't think you can practice that one.
No, that's tough to do. Colbert had a little bit too much juice on that one. It'll be second and 10 from the 12-yard line. 3:09 left here before halftime. Pitch outside, Blake Beetz. He's going to try to get to the corner, and he's going to go nowhere.
In fact, he may have lost a yard or so, huh? Well,
nice job there by Wagner.
It's kind of hard running to the short side of the field there. When
yep.
I don't know, this might be fourth down territory here anyway.
Might look at a field goal try too by McKean. It's into the wind though, we'll see. Semler in motion. Holzbauer gonna catch that one, and he's gonna cut up the middle. Nice cut, good blocks. Dawson Semler and Jordan McKean gonna open that up for him. That'll be Culbert's fourth touchdown pass tonight, Tony. Holzbauer with a 12-yard touchdown reception. Looks like we're lining up for the extra point. Holzbauer to snap, Scott to hold, McKean to kick. Kick is down, kick is up, kick is no good. That's going to go off to the left. So score 34-0 with 2:36 left before halftime. We want to talk about anything coming up next week?
No, like I said, I think our schedule is pretty quiet next week. The only thing we have is Monday's home game with volleyball. Against Mount Vernon Plank. And then the girls, I believe, I think they might go to Scotland on Thursday.
Okay.
But then I think they're on the road, and for the last three home games are home, but I think they have like five or six away. Like they have Trip Delmont Armor, they have Scotland, Platt Geddes. Those are three teams I know that they're on the road. So if you have not seen the girls play, come out Monday night. Otherwise, it'll be a while before they're back home. You looking up their schedule?
No, I was looking to see some other scores out there. I saw earlier that, breaking news, the mosquitoes are really bad in Mount Vernon, someone says. So
apparently they didn't spray there then.
All right.
I know Ethan's homecoming this week as well.
Okay, I did see that.
But I don't know.
Bridgewater, Emery, Ethan, and T are scoreless at the end of the first quarter.
Wonder where they're playing that at. Probably
doesn't say on here.
I don't think they play any games in Ethan anymore, do they?
My guess would be not. They got to have lights.
They're playing right now, yep.
Oh, I need all tweets here. And I saw that Tri-Valley was beating, I think it was Lennox, 30-0 in the first half. So McKean to kick. Going to be on the ground. Oh, it's a live ball.
And looks like Parkson gets the ball back.
See who comes up with it there.
Blake Beetz.
Or Brady Albrecht. I think that might have been Brady Albrecht with the ball there.
Well, I'm not going to disagree with Akery. He said Beetz.
Oh, did he? Okay.
That's what he said. But
55-35 looking.
He's got binoculars, I know.
Oh, does he? Okay. So 2:35 left here. Trojans will take over after the kick. It's a live ball. No one got on it for Wagner. Culbert back to pass again. He's going to step up. Passes away. Ooh. Leichner's open again. See if he can get by him.
And he does. And
the fifth touchdown pass for Culbert tonight. Fourth touchdown catch for Leichner. Made a nice move there at the end.
Once again, though he was open, Culbert had to make a nice step up because the guy grabbed him by the jersey but couldn't pull him down. Which yard line were we at? The 27?
So
27-yard
right
pass?
There. Yep. Trojans going for two.
quick hit up the middle. That's going to
be
good.
And Blake Beats is going to be good for two. So the fifth touchdown pass for Kellen Colbert tonight. Fourth touchdown catch for Leishner. The other one was to Holzbauer.
Holzbauer.
So I used to work with Braden on catching, so
catching them. You must not listen too close then.
I'm not sure why I even talk to you anymore. So.
Despite all that Mike's teaching, he still caught the ball, so.
Liam, can you cut Tony's mic? Are you able to just cut his mic and not mine? So. All right, once again, stay tuned at halftime as Royalty will be walking down, and we're going to stay there, so make sure our cameras don't turn off because we got someone that knows we're going to be doing that.
Actually, I think we'll be just using our center camera.
Okay. So make sure they don't shut everything off.
Yeah, we can use all three cameras. That's fine.
So Jordan McKean set to kick. Trojans 42, Wagner 0. Got some new kids in on kickoff here as well, Tony. Number 80, Nate Doring. Number 7, Rylan Leishner in on kickoff. McKean hard down the middle. That's going to be jumped on by Truman Ashes, about the 27-yard line. Wagner will take over first and 10. I think at halftime they announced the winners of the floats.
Yes.
Had a lot of entries this year.
Yes.
Which
we, I think the parade took about 32 minutes, if I remember. I recorded it. I'll try to get it uploaded early next week so you can watch it on Santel, and then I'll upload it to the Parkston Trojan Sports Live too, so you can watch it.
Excellent. Yeah, reminder that we have switched from the cube Fry in the backfield. He's going to keep it. Braden Leishner with the tackle, but not before he picks up about 8 yards. Bring up second and about two or three, Tony. I think I helped do three different floats this year. So, a little biased. I thought the senior parent float was probably the best one. So,
I was kind of partial to the swimming one that they did. That was kind of little play on words there.
Oh, the Lockie.
Yeah.
Yeah. Lockie up the Raiders.
Yeah.
Hand off to Soak up, and he's going to sneak up and
looks like close
to a
first
down.
Now he's still going to be. Nope,
first down.
Nope. Yep.
Nope. Okay. Sign line judge said first down. They're going to change it.
Now they're going to change it.
First down. So now we need a different play call for Wagner, I'm assuming.
Apparently that guy all the way across the field has better eyesight than the guy right by the flag here.
Fry in the backfield. The ball's loose. It's going to be picked up by...
He's going to be picked up by two guys, 31 and 39.
That was Soak up, picked up the loose ball, yeah. And Luke Beats.
And 31 and 39.
59.
39, wasn't it?
Slayton Negebauer.
59? Is there 5, a 39
10 sophomore.
Out there?
Nope.
Okay, then it's 59.
Yep. Now in a nose guard, number 51, TJ Biggie.
Yes, Slayton is starting to be a pretty good sized young man.
Yes, he is.
He has really grown over the last year or so. Be interested to see what he does on the wrestling mat this year.
Yep, did a nice job last year. Fry going to get stopped in the backfield by Leishner. He gets away from that, but then a host of Trojans bring him down. And that's going to be halftime. So with 42 points, for Parkston and zero for Wagner. There's that scoreboard, and we're going to stay right here as they go through the royalty. All four boys are football players. One of the girls, football manager. Two of the girls, football cheerleaders. And one of them, a volleyball player. So, as they get ready here, we'll get our camera people ready. Can we listen in to Mr. Acree as he announces it, or are we going to do that?
We can announce when they come across.
Okay.
I think we know him.
All right. Okay.
You know, that's the worst thing is you say someone's name and it's not the right person.
Yeah.
You ever had that moment when you know this person for many, many years of your life, and
yep.
then you start talking and you can't remember their name?
I'm bad at people's names. I know faces. I don't know names. Like first up, there on your screen, see if we can zoom in on them a little bit.
Whoop.
That's all right, we're still working on it.
We got people standing in front of our cameras now.
So Blake Beats and Brooklyn Van Zee walking through. King candidate Kellen Culbert and Nikki Weber. And next up, Alex Scott and Haley Belas. And your king and queen for 2016, Jordan McKean and Mackenzie McKean. They are brother and sister. They are twins.
And you know what? They didn't win on Twin Day either. You imagine that? The only twins, I believe. We got another pair.
They have another pair of twins?
Yep. The Manly boys.
Oh, okay. Yep. All right. All right. So there are your homecoming royalty. So we're going to take a break, and we'll be back in about 12 minutes.
Welcome to MDS Manufacturing, Inc., serving agriculture for over 50 years and creating tools that help you unleash your loader's potential. We are the premier manufacturer of agricultural attachment equipment. Our products are engineered and designed for quality, convenience, reliability, versatility, value, and safety. For over 50 years, we have been listening to our clients and working with them to provide products that improve their tractor loader needs. MDS Manufacturing in Parkston is leading the way with quality. Call or click today and let us help you pick out the best attachment that will do the job you want it to do. 1301 South Dakota Highway 37. Call 800-658-4703 or visit attachmentspecialist.com.
Shane Fish & Company Incorporated, your local certified public accountants. In need of an audit or simply needing to file your tax return, with helpful and friendly staff, they will be sure to put your books in order. Stop in at 105 East Main Street or call 605-928-7241 to see how they can help you. Shu Painting is ready to tackle all your painting needs. Their attention to detail with an uncompromised finish sets them apart. Shu Painting has done everything from homes to churches to garage floors. To get a quote for your next painting project, contact Shoe Painting at 605-996-1243 or stop in at 2019 East Havens Avenue, Mitchell, South Dakota, 57301.
It's a high-tech world for everyone, and everyone deserves connection.
Santel Communications is proud to be a supporter of Trojan TV. For over 60 years, Santel has connected thousands of customers to the world. We are your trusted and local leader in television entertainment, broadband, computers, and network connectivity. Click Santel.net, call 796-4411, or visit our office in Woonsocket.
We perfected connected Santel.
When life happens, trust the experts at Tracy's Paint and Body. Tracy's Paint and Body is a full-service auto body repair shop in Parkston. We feature 24-hour tow service along with full auto body repairs, ranging from windshield and hail dent repairs all the way to full vehicle body overhauls. We also feature full classic vehicle and tractor restoration. For the best price and the best service, visit Tracy's Paint and Body at 908 South Bend Street in Parkston or call 928-7600.
You, your machines, your operators, and Notaboom implements all working together through advanced practices and operating efficiencies to optimize quality, yield, and profits. Welcome to John Deere Farm Site, a strategy built around three key elements: your farm equipment, our technology solutions, your John Deere dealer, Notaboom implements. Now more than ever, the future of farming is in sight at Notaboom Implement in Corsica, Chamberlain, Parkston, and Platte, South Dakota. 100% family owned and operated.
CHS Farmers Alliance, serving East Central South Dakota. Farmers Alliance is a full-service agricultural cooperative. Our primary locations include Alexandria, Bridgewater, Chamberlain, Corsica, Ethan, Huron, Mitchell, Storla, and White Lake. Our primary purpose at Farmers Alliance is to help our customers succeed, for only then can Farmers Alliance be successful. This will be accomplished by providing superior products and creative solutions in agronomy, energy, feed, and grain. For more information, visit our website, www.farmersalliance.coop. Hanke Tractor Repair in Parkston is a family-owned and operated business offering the best in service, parts, and accessories for Articat, Toro, Ferris, Snapper, and Steel. We can handle all of your ATV, UTV, and log and garden equipment needs. We feature many products ranging from lawnmowers, chainsaws, leaf blowers, and other outdoor power equipment. We offer a full lineup of vehicles from Articat, and we also offer full-service repairs on your equipment. Come check out our selection, Hanke Tractor Repair, 711 West Maple, Parkston. Visit HankeTractorRepair.com or call 928-3252. Precision Machining.
Parkston Drug, your local hometown pharmacy and gifts. Find many fabulous accessories ranging from jewelry to purses and so much more. Is your home in need of a little spice? Stop in and see all the home decorations we have to offer. Looking for a gift for someone special? Well, we have something for every occasion. come on down to Parkston Main Street for all your pharmacy needs. While you're here, check out the many treasures you will find in store.
Welcome to MDS Manufacturing, Inc., serving agriculture for over 50 years and creating tools that help you unleash your loader's potential. We are the premier manufacturer of agricultural attachment equipment. Our products are engineered and designed for quality, convenience, reliability, versatility, value, and safety. For over 50 years, we have been listening to our clients and working with them to provide products that improve their tractor loader needs. MDS Manufacturing in Parkston is leading the way with quality. Call or click today and let us help you pick out the best attachment that will do the job you want it to do. 1301 South Dakota Highway 37. Call 800-658-4703 or visit attachmentspecialist.com.
Shane Fish & Company Incorporated, your local certified public accountants. In need of an audit or simply needing to file your tax return, with helpful and friendly staff, they will be sure to put your books in order. Stop in at 105 East Main Street or call 605-928-7241 to see how they can help you. Shu Painting is ready to tackle all your painting needs. Their attention to detail with an uncompromised finish sets them apart. Shu Painting has done everything from homes to churches to garage floors. To get a quote for your next painting project, contact Shu Painting at 605-996-1243 or stop in at 2019 East Havens Avenue, Mitchell, South Dakota, 57301.
It's a high-tech world for everyone, and everyone deserves connection.
Santel Communications is proud to be a supporter of Trojan TV. For over 60 years, Santel has connected thousands of customers to the world. We are your trusted and local leader in television entertainment, broadband, computers, and network connectivity. Click Santel.net, call 796-4411, or visit our office in Woonsocket.
We perfected connected Santel.
When life happens, trust the experts at Tracy's Paint and Body. Tracy's Paint and Body is a full-service auto body repair shop in Parkston. We feature 24-hour tow service along with full auto body repairs, ranging from windshield and hail dent repairs all the way to full vehicle body overhauls. We also feature full classic vehicle and tractor restoration. For the best price and the best service, visit Tracy's Paint and Body at 908 South Bend Street in Parkston or call 928-7600.
You, your machines, your operators, and Notaboom implements all working together through advanced practices and operating efficiencies to optimize quality, yield, and profits. Welcome to John Deere Farm Site, a strategy built around three key elements: your farm equipment, our technology solutions, your John Deere dealer. Notaboom implements, now more than ever. The future of farming is in sight at Notaboom Implement in Corsica, Chamberlain, Parkston, and Platte, South Dakota. 100% family owned and operated.
CHS Farmers Alliance, serving East Central South Dakota. Farmers Alliance is a full-service agricultural cooperative. Our primary locations include Alexandria, Bridgewater, Chamberlain, Corsica, Ethan, Huron, Mitchell, Storla, and White Lake. Our primary purpose at Farmers Alliance is to help our customers succeed, for only then can Farmers Alliance be successful. This will be accomplished by providing superior products and creative solutions in agronomy, energy, feed, and grain. For more information, visit our website, www.farmersalliance.coop. Hanke Tractor Repair in Parkston is a family-owned and operated business offering the best in service, parts, and accessories for Articat, Toro, Ferris, Snapper, and Steel. We can handle all of your ATV, UTV, and log and garden equipment needs. We feature many products ranging from lawnmowers, chainsaws, leaf blowers, and other outdoor power equipment. We offer a full lineup of vehicles through Articat, and we also offer full-service repairs on your equipment. Come check out our selection, Hanke Tractor Repair, 711 West Maple, Parkston. It's at HankeTractorRepair.com or call 928-3252. precisely what you need. Parchment Precision Machining.
Parkston Drug, your local hometown pharmacy and gifts. Find many fabulous accessories ranging from jewelry to purses and so much more. Is your home in need of a little spice? Stop in and see all the home decorations we have to offer. Looking for a gift for someone special? Well, we have something for every occasion. Come on down to Parkston Main Street for all your pharmacy needs. While you're here, check out the many treasures you will find in store.
Welcome to MDS Manufacturing, Inc., serving agriculture for over 50 years and creating tools that help you unleash your loader's potential. We are the premier manufacturer of agricultural attachment equipment. Our products are engineered and designed for quality, convenience, reliability, versatility, value, and safety. For over 50 years, we have been listening to our clients and working with them to provide products that improve their tractor loader needs. MDS Manufacturing in Parkston is leading the way with quality. Call or click today and let us help you pick out the best attachment that will do the job you want it to do. 1301 South Dakota Highway 37. Call 800-658-4703 or visit attachmentspecialist.com.
Shane Fish & Company Incorporated, your local certified public accountants. In need of an audit or simply needing to file your tax return, with helpful and friendly staff, they will be sure to put your books in order. Stop in at 105 East Main Street or call 605-928-7241 to see how they can help you. Shu Painting is ready to tackle all your painting needs. Their attention to detail with an uncompromised finish sets them apart. Shu Painting has done everything from homes to churches to garage floors. To get a quote for your next painting project, contact Shu Painting at 605-996-1243 or stop in at 2019 East Havens Avenue, Mitchell, South Dakota, 57301.
It's a high-tech world for everyone, and everyone deserves connection.
Santel Communications is proud to be a supporter of Trojan TV. For over 60 years, Santel has connected thousands of customers to the world. We are your trusted and local leader in television entertainment, broadband, computers, and network connectivity. Click Santel.net, call 796-4411, or visit our office in Woonsocket.
We perfected connected Santel.
When life happens, trust the experts at Tracy's Paint and Body. Tracy's Paint and Body is a full-service auto body repair shop in Parkston. We feature 24-hour tow service along with full auto body repairs, ranging from windshield and hail dent repairs all the way to full vehicle body overhauls. We also feature full classic vehicle and tractor restoration. For the best price and the best service, visit
all right, we're back here to start the second half. Parkston 42, Wagner 0. And Parkston won the toss in the first half and deferred to the second half. They'll take the football. Truman Ashes to kick off for Wagner.
We're laughing over here because the one camera all of a sudden got this big bug that flew right on the lens.
Tulsa Janish going to return this kick. Get to the outside. Good blocks. Nice job, gentlemen. And Truman Ashes and number 21, Ben Sokup with the tackle there on Janish. That'll be first and 10 for the Trojans. Looks like the starting offense will come back out. Once again, when one team leads by 35 points or more, the clock will continue to run in the second half. Hand off to Blake Beats up the middle. He's going to be stopped after a short gain of about three. Bring up second and seven. Once again, Parkston Media Club puts on this event, or all the events, I should say, on TV. These are all students running the cameras, doing the graphics, and running the, you are the producer, doing the producing. McKean to the bottom of your screen. Colbert under center. Semler going to get the inside. He's going to pick up about 5 yards. It's going to bring up third and I'm going to say three, Mr. Akey says. Short three, long two. We have our first person watching that let me know where they're watching from, Tony. So
Parkston?
Yep, they're watching from Parkston.
Probably in the school, maybe.
Oh, they're downtown, I'm going to say, Tony. Uh-oh, another fumble.
35.
Luke Beats with a great run up the middle. He gets hit from behind and knocks the ball out, but Blake Beats there to recover.
Big brother picking up.
Yeah, helping
little
him out.
Brother all left off, huh?
Helping him out.
I bet you he'll hear that one at home.
9:30, coming up on 9:30 left in the third quarter. Colbert going to keep it. I don't know if that was a design play. It looked like a busted play. Looks like he's going to pick up maybe a yard. That'll make it second and nine. Games like this, you want to try to get the game over quickly.
So what's the...
I believe 50.
50 and it's done?
50 and it's done. So maybe that's why we're trying to keep our starting lineup in. Blake Beats. Off the right-hand side, he's going to pick up about 4 yards. It'll be third and five. Want to get out of these games without an injury.
That's for sure, especially when you're up by this much.
Yep. So I see we got a bunch of different linemen in. Getting some experience on those young guys. TJ Biggie and Slayton Negebauer in. Semler off the left-hand side. He's going to pick up about a yard. That's going to bring up fourth and four. We'll see what Coach Norton's dialing up here.
Let's see, Kellen roll out to the right. And Leishner open in the end zone in the right-hand corner. How's that sound?
We will have to see here. Colbert back to pass.
Oh, he switched sides.
Beats off to the left-hand side. Nice running, and he's going to get knocked out of bounds at about the 15, 14-yard line. It'll be first and 10 for the Trojans. Nice little swing pass. The wide receivers cleared everybody out, and Blake went off to the left-hand side all by himself. Needed four, picked up about 20.
First and 10 and 13, 6:52, clock continues to run. Colbert under center, and we got a timeout called by McKean.
I think he was on the wrong side. I think Paul Peterson, the tackle, was uncovered on that other side, and that's an illegal formation. So either Braden or Jordan was on the wrong side there. One of them got to get that other tackle covered up. So Parkston with the timeout. 6:42 left here in the third quarter. Did anybody write down the winners for the parade? I'll see if I can get them for Mr. Acree.
Good. I think I remember them, but yeah, it's better to make sure we're accurate. Okay, we'll start with the school first. Eighth graders, you guys didn't fare too well. Second place went to the junior class, which
I can't remember what they did.
Well, they were squirting people with their squirt guns.
Ah, yes. And it got warm out there, too,
yeah,
so I didn't mind it at all.
They tried to get me on the camera, but it didn't work. And then the seventh grade, what did the seventh graders do?
They did volleyball.
Volleyball, okay.
We'll spike the Raiders. Blake Beats up the middle, and he's in. No, that was that Beats? No, that was Dawson Semler, I think. That was Dawson Semler. Dawson Semler up the middle.
2 points?
No, they're going for one.
They're going for one.
Maybe we'll see a trick play here that they can work. They need to work on. Holzbauer to snap, Scott to hold, McKean to kick. Kick is low and it's no good. Last few games, the extra points have been solid.
We haven't made one tonight yet, have we?
Not so tonight, no. So Parkston 48, Wagner 0. Go ahead with those.
Oh, no, we're going to take a break.
Oh, we're going to take a break? Okay.
Then we'll come back with the business results.
CHS Farmers Alliance, serving East Central South Dakota. Farmers Alliance is a full-service agricultural cooperative. Our primary location...
All right, we're back here, third quarter, 6:31 left in the third. Dawson Semler with a 12-yard touchdown scamper. McKean to kick off.
Wagner will start right on their 30.
Covered up by number 74, Cole Solchek. That'll bring up first and 10 for Wagner. Once again, Trojans lead by more than 35 points, so the clock will continue to run, coming up on 6 minutes. I believe they only stop it for timeouts or injuries.
Okay, once again, the parade results for the school. Second went to junior class and first went to seventh grade. They don't do the elementary anymore, do they?
No, they do not.
They just all get candy.
And they certainly do. There were bags and bags of it out there. All right, and this time Parkston's going to take another timeout here. 5:42 left. Looks like we were missing some personnel out there.
I do have to say, I have to give Mr. Timmons a bad time because he was standing by me, and he had to go out and get some candy too because he had the caramels and the Smarties were his favorite.
Okay.
So. Okay, so here we go. The results for the business
parade winners. We'll start with the honorable mentions. I don't know. There wasn't anything special about
this. Was a quality float is all I have to say.
From the senior parents. I don't know.
Yep, senior parent float, quality.
Apparently, so, Mike, you didn't have anything to do with that one, did
so
you?
So that was our seniors are golden. So
it just says HM.
Honorable mention. That works.
Then third went to Eglin Co-op. What did they have?
Trying to remember. They had the boxers or something, didn't they?
Oh, yes.
The boxers?
Okay.
Yeah.
Well.
Glenda Kurtz was.
No, that would have been.
Well, that Casey's. Oh, sorry.
Sorry, Eglin Co-op. We can't remember what.
Can't remember, no.
Then, second place, Farmer State Bank.
Very good, yeah. They had a rowing. I actually just helped on this one. I had nothing to do with that one, Tony, so. Fry back to pass, and it's complete.
Nice pass and return, and takes all the way up to the 48-yard line of Wagner.
Zephyr with the catch, and it'll be first down. And first place?
First place. Oh, they didn't write it down. Sorry, it's known.
They had first place in there. I'm pretty sure I even know who it is.
Who is it?
Parkston Grain and Feed? Parkston and Kaler Grain and Feed.
They just have grain. They didn't say grain and feed. So.
No. They had a nice play on words there.
Yep. That's what I said. I thought that was the one with the Lochte, right?
Yep. Ball, loose ball. And
Parks will take over on right on about the 50-yard line, right?
Nope, yes.
40.
Yeah, Fry tried to hand off to Soakup, and then he tried to pull it back, and I think Soakup wanted to keep it. That's one of those reads that's hard. Ball pops out.
So once again, very quickly, the business's honorable mention goes to the senior parents. Third place goes to Eglin Co-op. Second place goes to Farmer State Bank. And congratulations, first place to Parkston, Kaler Grain and Feed.
Nate Bechter in a quarterback right now under center. He's going to hand off to Blake Beats off the right-hand side, and he's going to pick up about 7.
I do have to say the Parkston Dentistry had a very unique. They weren't throwing out candy. They were throwing out toothbrushes today.
Toothbrushes.
And I heard one of the parents say, I don't know if my child knows how to use one of those.
Oh, geez. But that's why you're drumming up some business, so
yep.
That's a good idea. Number 7, Ryland Leishner, and number 32, Tulsa Janish, and he's going to get met in the backfield by number 81, St. Pierre. He busted that play up. Third down and 4 with 3 minutes left here in the third quarter.
There was a St. Pierre, was he at USF?
Yep. I think he was trying out for one of the NFL teams. He didn't get drafted.
I thought it was the Raiders at one time, but it
could have been. McKean split out to the bottom of your screen here. Bechter with the keeper. See if he can get to the outside. He cuts it back up. He's going to get met right at about the 40-yard line, and I think he's going to be just a hair short. Mr. Acree says 4th and 1.
So have you heard if the mosquitoes got any better in Mount Vernon? Or
I think that was Ryan Deal from the Mitchell Daily Republic. So let me see what's going on here.
I don't see our chain gang. It's just probably just enough breeze yet.
Yep, the breeze actually picked up just a little bit. Nate Bechter going to go straight up the middle, and he's going to keep the football, and he's going to get enough for the first down. Mitchell 55-0 over Spearfish at halftime. They've got a good year going up there in Mitchell.
So is that not over, or they continue?
I don't know about double A. That's a good question.
It's probably a long drive to play. Was that at half?
Or that was at half, it said, yes. Tri-Valley leading Lennox 38-0 at halftime. Or, excuse me, in the third quarter. Janish going up the middle. He's going to get met by number 44, Dawson Petrick. Oh, we got an injury timeout here. Noah Flying Hawk limping to the sidelines there. Hopefully he's all right. Mount Vernon Plank 40, Woolsey Wessington Sanborn Central. Woolsey Wessington Springs Sanborn Central 26. So that's Mount Vernon Plank 40, 26. And Bechter's going to keep it. He's going to break out to the corner. Let's see if he gets away.
And that's all it will take.
And I believe that's your ball game, folks. Nate Bechter with a 35-yard touchdown run. And that's the game. Once again, 50-point lead is the game.
And, of course, our favorite AD just walks up. She wants to clean the windows now.
I just wanted to stop on real quick and talk about what we have going on Monday night at our home volleyball match against Mount Vernon Plake. The director of the Fast Pitch Softball Tournament in Mitchell, called the Tana Kingsbury Memorial Tournament, has contacted me, and this year their guest of honor was our very own Sam Kinneberg. So they will be at the volleyball match on Monday night to present Sam and her family, our very own Tony next to me, with a check for $500 as part of their tournament that they raise money for. Sam was the guest of honor?
Yes, she was. In fact, she threw out the first pitch, and she played with one of the Mitchell teams 2 years ago when Parkson didn't have a team, and they traveled and played in the league in Madison. So, yeah, she players from Mount Vernon, Mitchell, Ethan, and Parkston made up that team, and she had a wonderful time. So she has a little passion to play softball, and so when she was diagnosed as aplastic anemia, they wanted to have her come out, and so she did this past summer. It was a really good turnout, and it was nice to see the softball players that she's played with, and she's hoping that maybe next year she'll be able to return to the softball field and do other activities as well than just softball, but we'll just have to wait and see. But and it's kind of unique because it's also her birthday that night. It just happened to be worked out great, and I know she's excited about it. So,
well, like you said, with playing with some of those Mount Vernon Plankington girls and having it be a birthday night, you're right, it couldn't have worked out any better.
Yes.
The only way it can get better is if we win that night on
yeah.
top of it.
Yeah. And that's the actually was Travis Walls from Mount Vernon area, and the two Walls girls that are I'm sure that we'll see on the volleyball court that mm-hmm. but yeah, they've been Cam special friends to the family and especially Samantha's. So yeah, that she's definitely looking forward to it, and it's greatly appreciated all the what they've done for our family. So
all right, well, hope to see you guys Monday night. If not, it'll be broadcast. You can watch it live.
Yes, that's for sure. Tell us what are some events coming up.
Well, we've got a busy week ahead.
Thursday you go to Scotland, correct?
Thursday, yep. Well, let's start at the beginning. Monday we host Mount Vernon Plankington. Tuesday we head to Trip to battle TDA Nighthawks. Wednesday we get a little bit of a break. And then Thursday we're on the road to Scotland. So there are three volleyball matches next week. But we're not the only ones who are busy. The boys golfers have their regional tournament.
That's right, yes.
At Lakeview on Monday. So I'll be up helping run the tournament with Coach Hockett on Monday, and that's when they find out if they can qualify for state, which will be in Rapid City
yes.
at Hart Ranch Golf Course. Cross country is also in action on Monday. They're heading over to West Central at Hartford, at a park in Hartford they'll be running. And then we host Wagner in junior high football, and our JV football team will travel there.
Okay.
And that's just Monday.
That's just Monday.
That's just Monday. That's a busy day. I got that one in. Yeah, Mr. Scott's over here giving me a hard time because he's cleaning the windows and not paying attention.
Yeah, he's not paying attention. Yeah, it's going to be a busy
busy, busy week. Like I said, then we're in Scotland.
In Scotland on Thursday night, and that's the whole boat. You know, we start on, this is on Tuesday and Thursday. We play 7th grade, 8th grade, C team, JV, and varsity. It'll be a full night of volleyball for both.
Yep, and that's not all bad, because as a parent, if you have a couple of the younger kids and older kids, you get to see quite a bit of volleyball that night.
Yep, you can make the long haul, settle in with a good hot dog and watch a lot of good volleyball, hopefully.
You know, what's really amazing, this is already our third home game. We only have one more home game left in 2 weeks against Winter.
Right.
You know, and then potentially we might be on the road the rest of the time.
Right, and our road trips are not short ones, that's for sure. We've got Jones County Murdo left, and then up to Groton area schools. So the guys got a great win tonight, a great cap to homecoming week. And
we had a wonderful homecoming
week. Yeah, I thought the games today went well, yep, the activities.
The kids did a wonderful job. They participated. They dressed up. I mean, I thought it was a wonderful job by our – and it kind of is a reflection of our king and queen this year.
Yeah, our student council, which they're the president and vice president. They did a nice job of – leading the activities and coming up with some fun things for the kids to do. I enjoyed the dodgeball myself, but everything was a good time.
Yeah, you were kind of throwing a ball around. I don't know if that's fair if you got a teacher throwing dodgeballs at students, but.
Well, I had a great lead blocker named Alex Scott.
So. Oh, yeah. Stood right in front and protected you.
not my first dodgeball game. It was fun.
But you guys are going to be road warriors for a few weeks now, right?
Yeah, our schedule doesn't get a whole lot lighter. Like I said, we're on the road next week.
TDA and Platte Geddes, is that?
We've got Platte Geddes the following week.
Okay.
Yep, and they're a salty program too. We saw them at the Cavalier Clash last weekend, and they've got some great hitting middles that we'll have to defend.
And then TDA sometime the following week?
TDA is Tuesday, yep. Everything's going to be in trip on Tuesday, which makes for a nice road trip on Murdo and Groton these boys are in store for.
And then who else do you play on the road before you're back home? You remember?
We've got... I should have prepped on my own schedule, too. I know everybody else is. We've got Wagner on the road in that mix. We've got Bonhomme at home before the end of the season. We end our season with Madison at home, which would be our longest road trip of the season. And then we do, in about a month from yesterday, we have our SESD tournament, which is some really, really good volleyball. And that will be hosted in Wagner this year. Yep. That'll be October 22nd, I believe, if I've got my dates correct.
You know, this fall season goes by, like I said, you know, the golfers region, we want to wish them the best of luck. And the pre-region end up in second place as a team?
Yep, they did. So if they...
And we're awfully young.
Yes, we are. And if they place in the top three as a team, then they qualify as a team and get to go. The other way to qualify would be in the top 60% of the field.
And at that, we made it, didn't we?
Yes, I think all of our golfers would have. We had Jake Lee, who was in the running right up at the top. He did a nice job. He's been leading the team all season. You look at some of the young kids, Braden Bruning and Carter Calda, who we only get to take five to the region team. But they ended the season with the best rounds they've had all year, and that's where you want
to
be.
It's a good time to start playing. Yes,
you want to end on top. So they did a nice job, and Alex will be back on the team on Monday, and so I expect.
And who was the other one? Quinn.
And Quinn Borman, yeah.
And that they'll take the five.
Yep. So and then Nate Hone is also on the varsity team. So and he's been golfing very well as well.
Yeah, we want to wish them the best luck. Like I said, Parks has done well in golf over the years, and. Mm-hmm. Like I said, we're awfully young there, so there's a lot of potential coming up in the younger ranks there, so it's good to see.
Yep. They'll be heading out to Hart Ranch October 3rd and 4th for the state tournament, hopefully. I don't want to jump the gun on that, but that's where they'll be at, and that's a beautiful course, and I know several of them have played it before, so they've got a little bit of experience.
Yeah, that is a tough course. Beautiful course, but that is a tough course.
Yeah. Yes, definitely. Well,
we'll let you go, and... So you can get all the money put away and whatever else you need to do.
All those fun tasks. The windows are clean, though. Mr. Scott took care of that for me.
Only his side, though, you notice.
Yeah. Yeah, his wingspan isn't what it used to be.
So, well, we want to thank you very much for coming up. And like I said, we wish the girls best luck. It's, you played some tough competition, and you were definitely making strides in the right direction. So we hope that the second half of the season now that you can continue to improve and get some wins under your belt and wish you the best of luck.
Well, thank you. It's a fun group to work with.
Yes, and, they are.
I've been enjoying the year so far.
Good.
Yep.
Okay. So they will be here Monday night, Mount Vernon Plank. And that's once again 7 through varsity, right?
Not on Monday.
Monday
will just be C team starting at 5 o'clock, okay. Followed by JV and varsity. But Tuesday and Thursday, the whole boat.
Okay.
The whole load, yep. A lot of good volleyball.
And I don't know if those other teams, I don't know if Scotland or those other teams broadcast.
I'm not sure, to be honest
with
you. Not that I know of.
Yeah.
Not that I know of, but everybody's kind of doing their own thing this year.
Yeah.
So if it is broadcast, I will be sure to put it out on Twitter, let Tony know on the website, and try to get that information out.
Yes.
But at this point, not that I know of.
Yes. Okay.
All right.
Well, thank you very much.
Thanks.
And we'll talk to you later.
Yeah.
And we're going to bring Mike back on. I think he has some scores. You guys can put something on our screen if you want, to at least people know that we're...
Oh, no, I was just trying to get a hold of Ryan Deal to see if the mosquitoes were any better in Mount Vernon for you, Tony. So,
and like I said, we had enough breeze tonight. I'm surprised maybe in Mount Vernon, their field's on the north part of town, though, so maybe it...
Right, right. So put up those playoff points again. I don't know, can you do that? And you can see the... So if you need to know how this works, you get so many points for a victory, and if then it goes by their record on how many points you actually get. So I think we'll pick up 41 points, and you divide that total points by how many games you've played. And so we'll pick up a few points there, but we need other teams to win, such as Tri-Valley, T-Area, things like that, the teams we've lost to. We need them to continue to win.
Do we get a score on who's playing T tonight? Bridgewater, Emory, Ethan, right?
Bridgewater, Emory, Ethan. I was trying to find some. Seahawks lead 14-13 heading into the fourth quarter.
Oh, close game.
So close game there, yes. And just going off the Twitter, and I'm not finding any more here as of right now that pertains to us, Tony. A lot of double A school scores. And Tri-Valley 38-0 over Lennox in the third quarter. So.
Okay, well, I guess with that, like I said, we're 5 games now into our season. Our next home game will be in 2 weeks, and that will be against Winter. And, of course, we know what kind of team Winter has, so that'll be an interesting matchup, just to kind of see where we're at. And, of course, Jody Brozek will be here. And
okay.
So.
Do you want him to come up and...
Well, he wants to run his own because he has, so I don't know.
Okay,
we might have to, I don't know if Winter brings
a radio station
or not or two. So, but we'll see what we can arrange. I know Jody's already texted me and wondering about where we can set him up. Other than that, like I said, it was a great week for homecoming. And our student body did a wonderful job. It was good to see in the gym as they were doing a pep rally and everything, and had a lot of school spirit and a lot of kids all dressed up today, so it was really fun to see a great parade. And to top it off, we get a nice win over in three quarters, wasn't it?
Yes, it
before
was.
Before three quarters.
Yep. 54-0 victory for the Trojans tonight.
So other than that, there's not much else I guess we can say, is that Parkson now will move to 3-2, and we'll just have to see how the other teams if they even play this week, if some of them have buys or not, I don't know. But I guess we'll just have to see where.
Kind of pulling for T area there.
Yes,
no offense, Bridgewater, Emory, Ethan people, but.
It's hard. It's, you know, when you're jumping up and then we have a lot of these teams don't play the same teams that we played. And so it's hard to tell where you're going to end up in. But 4 or 3 weeks from now, we will know probably.
Yes, we will.
Or 4 weeks because we have a buy that
we'll
one week.
We'll keep everybody informed.
Yeah. So, once again, we want to thank Mike for helping us out up top. And our crew, Liam, who did we have tonight? We had Liam and TJ up top. John Akery was doing the right camera, which... John Polrise, right?
Josh.
And, I'm
Josh,
sorry,
Josh,
not, Josh Polrise, I'm
there
sorry.
You go.
And then we had Ethan Poor.
Gordon Cipolla.
Gordon
Cipolla.
Cipolla.
Excuse me.
And I think we had a Weber boy over there helping out for a little bit, too.
Yep, Reagan was here helping, too.
Great job again tonight. You know, I love how those guys just chip in. I don't even have to tell them. They took the cameras already apart, and they're already at the school. And Now it's just a matter of shut down and get out of here for the night. But we're going to get out of here early. So,
all right.
So with that, Mike, once again, thanks a lot. And we hope everyone enjoyed the coverage and a great night for Parks and Football and a great weekend. A great week of homecoming festival activities. So with that, we're going to sign off and we will be back here Monday night, volleyball. So everyone have a great weekend and take care and we'll see you Monday night.